A power spacewalk outside the space station, honoring a former hidden figure, and a way cool find of a hot Jupiter. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA.
I am clear. Tether's clear. Bob can double check me. I verify you're clear.
On June 26th, our Chris Cassidy and Bob Behnken worked outside the International Space Station to replace aging nickel hydrogen batteries in one of the station's power channels with new lithium ion batteries.
All right, Bob, finally heading your way.
Sounds good.
The battery replacement work is the culmination of power upgrade spacewalks that began in January 2017. On June 24th, our Administrator Jim Bridenstine announced that our headquarters building in Washington, D.C. will be named after Mary W. Jackson, the first African-American female engineer at NASA. Jackson was part of a group of very important women whose math and scientific acumen helped to safely get American astronauts to space and back. These women were portrayed in the book Hidden Figures and popular movie of the same name. Our planet-hunting TESS spacecraft and data from our recently retired Spitzer Space Telescope helped identify the youngest known hot Jupiter, a type of gas-dominated exoplanet that orbits extremely close to its parent star. The planet, located about 490 light-years from Earth, is believed to be less than 17 million years old and could teach us more about how planets form throughout the universe. The moon in the binary near-Earth asteroid system Didymos, that was previously known as Didymos B, has been officially named Dimorphos. In 2022, it will be the target of our double asteroid redirection test, the first full-scale demonstration of an asteroid deflection technology for planetary defense. We've started a new effort to enable astronauts, principal investigators, and other NASA personnel to fly on future commercial suborbital spaceflights. These flights are anticipated to be more accessible, affordable, and available than missions to the International Space Station and could provide additional commercial human spaceflights for research, training, and testing activities. Our Solar Dynamics Observatory has been watching the sun for over a decade. This 10-year time lapse compresses each day into a second, showing the rise and fall in solar activity and notable events like transiting planets and eruptions. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.